Hello students, we shall now move on to the last machine independent feature, which is control section and program linking. Now you have already seen program blocks, right? Okay, so what did we see in program blocks? In the program blocks, we generated only one single object program and the instructions were rearranged in that object program. Whereas in control sections, what we can do is, here we can create separate object programs for each of the sections in a particular program. Okay, that is when program is divided into control sections, for each of the control section you can have a different object program, that is a separate object program for each of the control sections. So what is the advantage of this? That is, in this case you can load or relocate the control sections independently of the other control sections. So this is oftenly used for subroutines. Okay, that is, the programmer can also assemble, load and manipulate each of the control sections separately. Okay, so but then since we are separating the instructions into control sections, there should be one way to link each other, right? So for linking also we need to have some means. So because of this, there should be some means for linking control sections together. We will see that. Okay, now how do you declare control section is through an assembler directive called as cset, which is control section. Now the syntax is, you will have to decide on the name of the control section followed by the directive cset. As you have seen in the previous one, for each of the data blocks you had LOCCTR maintained, right? Similarly here also, for each of the control section you maintain a LOCCTR. Okay, so here we have an example given. Okay, so before moving to the example, as I said, since we are dividing the program into control sections, there should be some means to link these control sections, right? And that is done through a variable by name extdef. This is also a directive. Okay, external definition and external reference. Okay, so instruction, so what happens is, instruction in one record or the control section may need to refer to instructions in other control section, right? So we make use of external definition, which is given by the directive extdef. So what is the purpose of extdef? This is used when the symbols that are generated in one particular control section, or wherever you are defining extdef, right, under that particular control section you are defining some symbols, right? If at all those symbols are used in other control sections, then you will have to mention it using extdef. That means extdef name symbols that are defined in this control section and may be used in other control sections. External reference is opposite of this, that is extref means, suppose you are considering a particular control section now, so if you are using symbols which are defined elsewhere but used in the current control section that you are talking about, that is mentioned through extref. This is with respect to a current control section. Okay, extdef and extref is spoken right now with respect to one current control section. So extdef will have symbols that are defined in the current control section but used elsewhere also. Okay, so all those symbols should be defined here. Now what is external reference? All those symbols that are defined in other control sections or created in other control sections are used here. That is when you use extref. See, for example, okay, let's take an example, guys. Yeah, so yeah, so here you can see three control sections here. What is this? This is one control section here. Okay, fine. So this is one control section, clear? This is a default control section. As you can see, the control section has these many labels. If at all the labels that are defined here are used, this is the name of the control section, first control section, copy. Okay, if at all the labels that are used defined here are used elsewhere, then all that should be written here. See, for example, guys. Yeah. Now, buffer, buffend, and length are generated by this control section, but used elsewhere. Okay, I'll show you where it is used. Remember, buffer, buffend, and length, right? So this is the first control section, and this is the second control section. Can you see buffer, length, and buffend used here in the other control section? Yes. If so, then when speaking about this particular, we are now considering this particular control section, right? This one, yeah, first control section. So for the first control section, its symbols are used elsewhere, which is buffer, buffend, and length. So it is defined under extdef. Now in extref, for this control section, this control section uses the symbols that are defined in the other control section, which is that rdrec and wrrec. Okay, that means in the next one, see here, the external symbol here is RDREC, right? Okay, so it is in the second control section. Similarly, WREC is in the third control section, which is now used in the first control section. So that has to come under EXTREF. Now considering from the perspective of second control section. In second control section here, it's EXTREF is nothing but it uses buffer, length, and buffend, which is defined in the first control section, and it uses it. Okay, EXTREF uses buffer, length, and buffend, but it is defined in the other or the first control section. So it is mentioned over here. Okay, now similarly, considering the other control section, so this has to be the third control section, guys. Okay, this has to be third control section. Okay, so what happens here is, here you can see in EXTDF also you use length and buffer, but buffend is not used, right? So length and buffer, which is defined by the first control section, is used in this third control section. So that has to come under EXTREF. Clear? Okay, so this is what is control section. Fine. So we have three control sections here, and SCT is the directive that is used to define control sections. And in control sections, you have two extra directives by name EXTDF and EXTREF. EXTDF is used when the symbols generated by the current control section is used elsewhere. EXTREF is used when the symbols defined by some other control section is now currently being used in the current section that you are mentioning. Okay, so that is one thing that you need to make sure you write properly, because this program is divided into control sections, right? And if the control sections have to be linked with each other, because they are dependent on each other, right, for values. So we have to have a linking. So that is done through EXTDF and EXTREF. Now, here, as I said, for each of the control sections, you have different object programs. Like in this, you had three control sections, right? So using control sections, you can have three different object programs for the corresponding three control sections. So apart from header, apart from text record and the end record and the modification record that you saw in program relocation, you have two extra records, that is defined record and refer record to. So what are the information in defined record? D, right? After D, you need to have the name of the external symbols defined in this control section. See, for example, let me take with respect to the first control section. So what are its own variables? Length, buffer, and buffend. So you need to mention the name here, followed by its address relative to the particular control section. So where does exactly length, where does exactly buffer and buffend are relative to the starting of the particular control section, that needs to be written. Okay, in refer record, it indicates R is a refer record, and here you need to write all the symbols that are defined elsewhere but used in the in this control section. Okay, so let me take an example here. Okay, Here I'll give you an example. Now with respect to the definition record of the first control section, let me write here. Okay, so D, after that what did I say? The buffer. Okay, buffer is its own. I'll just write B. Okay, yeah, buff here. I'll write completely. Now what should you include next? In the next, where does buffer exactly sit? Okay, so you have to include the address of buffer here. Let's say the address is somewhere at 0066. Okay, that should be written. Okay, yeah. Now, what about buffin? So next you have to write buffin and its respective address. That is, buffin's address should be written. Okay, similarly, it should be followed by length. That is, the length address. What is the address of length? That should be written. That is, for this particular control section, the definition record will have its own symbols which are used elsewhere along with their addresses relative to its own control section. Okay, so that is what you have in the defined record. Now coming to our record. Our record will have, this is a reference record, right? So it will have information of the symbols that are defined elsewhere but used in this control section. So which are they? You know that they are RDREC and WRREC. So you need to write RDREC, just the names, RDREC and WRREC. No including their addresses, because they're just symbols that are referred. Okay, so just include their names, but in the defined record you need to have the names as well as their address that is relative to the particular control section that you're considering. Thank you.